Hey, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Evgeny Ternovsky. How are you?
I'm doing well. Yourself, sir?
I'm fabulous, and I've got a lot of log files that I need to deal with, and I understand that you have a solution for me.
I sure do. It's called, conveniently enough, Azure Log Analytics.
Very creative name. Like it.
Yeah.
Like it. So what produces these log files, and what does Log Analytics let me do to process them?
Sure. So Log Analytics pulls files in from a bunch of different places, from the simplest format, which is just an agent routing on your machines, sort of the classic SCOM approach, if you will, to being able to pull data in from all sorts of PaaS resources. For example, if you have some hypervisor set up, you can pull in from the hypervisor and the guest as well. And like I said, PaaS, so for example, Office 365, you can pull data in from and a bunch of other places. Backup Restore is fully integrated. Azure Automation is fully integrated. And the idea is you install various solutions on top of this data, and they pull data in, they offer you views on top of that data, they allow you to create alerts on top of that data, and of course, the part that we'll be talking about today, to query the raw data to really get the insights that you need.
So all of these different things within Azure create logs, I think of as at different levels, like IIS, for years has made a very specific format, and usually it just ends up being a pile of text files that I struggle with.
Right.
I assume Office 365 makes slightly more sophisticated because
sure.
it came out later.
Sure, sure.
Some of this is structured, some of this is somewhat less structured.
Yeah.
Is Azure Log Analytics normalizing that, or how does it think about these different formats?
Yeah, so the beauty of Azure Log Analytics is that every solution defines its own schema. And actually, part of what we'll be talking about today, which is the upgrade process to this new query language that we're introducing, actually exposes the schema to you. So previously, it was much more sort of full text, you know, dgrep style, just type in a keyword and get a result.
Right.
We're actually exposing the schema to you and letting you explore all of that. Right. So, and you can pull custom logs in as well, and you can decide what you want to do there. But every solution will kind of define the schema.
Interesting. Could my application, if I made a banking system or if I decided to write Amazon.com over again, could I make my own schema and that could be treated itself as a custom structure?
Yeah, you could. I mean, if you're doing application telemetry, I would actually point you to another service called Application Insights in Azure. And that's sort of our APM offering, our application performance management. Now, the beauty is it shares the exact same query language that we'll look at today. So you only have to learn one system, and you'll have all your data.
Okay, cool. So if I learn this new query language, I'm going to be well set up to query really anything within Azure that can create logs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool. Let's see a demo.
Sure. So I'm actually over here in an instance of Azure Log Analytics that I've previously provisioned. And Azure Log Analytics is a service that's been around for a while, so we actually had a previous way to query your logs. Now, this new query language that we're introducing, the conversion process is really simple. You see this purple bar here says Azure Log Analytics is now enhanced. And there's sort of a secondary portal to all of this called OMS. For those of you who are watching who know about this, the bar will be there as well, but we'll just stick to Azure for now. I'll press that bar. It'll give me some instructions here. You can read through that on your own time, but I'll press Upgrade Now. And typically, this takes less than 30 seconds. What's happening in the background is everything that you had saved before, your queries, your alerts, your custom views, all of this, we have a translator running in the background that actually translates all of this to the new language and resaves it for you. We also take a snapshot, so if for whatever reason you do need to roll back, you can go back to the exact state where you migrated.
Okay.
And you notice that pretty quickly the upgrade was successfully completed.
So that seems like a fairly harmless migration. If people are already using this, it's really not something that they should worry about.
Absolutely. We've actually been doing this with some customers, both internal and external, as part of a private preview type of program for about 2 months now. And so we feel pretty good that this is now stable. And this system, by the way, like I said, it's used in Application Insights, and it's used internally at Microsoft to store all of our telemetry. So we have close to 100 petabytes across all of these different systems already.
Wow, okay.
So if you've ever used Log Analytics, this will look pretty familiar. And if I know the new query language, I can just start typing queries in. If I know the previous language, though, that translator that I mentioned, I can manually invoke it.
So even if I have one lying around or in an email or a text file,
absolutely,
I could convert it and then save it.
Yeah, so here's a sample query, a very simple one. I just want to see all my heartbeat data. I'll press convert, it'll run that, and here's the new query. And I can now press search, and everything looks exactly the same.
Wow, that was really fast, though.
Yeah.
That's real.
Yeah, this is all...
all live.
Absolutely. And the data, of course, is real, too.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a bunch of options here. Everything you're used to in Azure Log Analytics is here, your saved searches, your Power BI, your export to Excel. But you'll notice this new Advanced Analytics button. And so because this query language is a lot more advanced than what you used to have available to you, we actually are providing now a dedicated query experience, sort of an IDE for querying, if you will.
Okay.
And so folks who've been using Application Insights have already had access to this for a while, but I'll show you what that does anyway.
Mm-hmm.
For the sake of time, I won't press that button, but if you do, you'll end up in a window like this.
Okay.
And remember, we talked about the schema. Here's all your different solutions. So for example, here's the update solution. Here's the tables associated with that. Let's actually zoom in a little here. And if I expand one of that, of course, you'll see all the different fields that are included. Then you'll notice that they're strongly typed as well. And I can start typing in. So one of the coolest things about this is IntelliSense is all over the place. Previously, you haven't had that. So if, let's say I want to take a look at my perf data. I'll start typing in perf. That
comes up. In the past, you were just kind of dropped into this text box.
Right, exactly.
Good luck.
Yeah.
This
so
is cool.
I'll press tab to lock it in. And now it knows here's all the different operators you can do with that. So I might say, you know, where counter name is equal to pages per second, like that.
Right.
And notice, by the way, all the different string comparison options that we have, from regex to full text to case sensitive, insensitive.
And I saw the squigglies that were happening while you were doing that, and then it went away when it knew it was a good query.
Yeah. And now I can just say, you know, something like...
what's this little eye here? Can you back up?
Sure.
You were typing. Do you get help as well?
You sure do. If you press that little thing, you get a little reference. So I can say take 10. And by the way, so let's press go over here. I'll show you what the results look like and then hold that thought. So here's all the different values, right? Here's just the representative 10 values.
Right.
I can press this little chevron over here, and this will actually expand every row, so I can kind of have more real estate to read what I'm looking at.
Right.
I can, of course, press the column grid, do, you know, all the typical grid stuff that you'd expect to
be able
to do. So I mentioned the help system, right?
Right.
As part of this update, we're actually rolling out a pretty extensive help system. And so if you press this little book icon over here, documentation, you get to this website. Let's zoom out a little bit.
Look at that.
So I'll press get started. We've put together a bunch of tutorials for you, a bunch of different ways to get started. And in the tutorials, sometimes you'll see this run query button. We've actually, Zoom it isn't cooperating, so I'll keep it zoomed out. We've actually spun up an instance of Azure Log Analytics with pre-populated data that anyone can come in. You don't even need to log in. You can start coming in and just playing around with it. So we've got tutorials if you're coming in from another querying system, for example, the legacy language. We've got nice convenient cheat sheets.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got a full language reference as well. So if let's say I wanted to learn more about how to do aggregations, which is the summarize operator, I can come in here and there's extensive documentation for everything that we're doing.
That's pretty slick. And the ability to run those queries and try them out. So as you're learning those concepts, you can go and run the query and see it happen for real against an anonymous instance of that.
Yeah, and you can, you know, start appending to the query and seeing exactly how things work.
You showed me a couple of basic queries, but can you show me a complicated one? Show me something scary.
So let's flip over here. First of all, just real quick about the scale and perf of the system. So let's say I wanted to take a look at all my performance data over the last 90 days.
Mm-hmm.
In just about 5 seconds, we get back 1.2 billion records.
Wow.
Right? Now, let's say I wanted to see the number of records and their average value for each counter. So I can press that, and in just a second, I get every distinct counter I have in the system, the number of values, and the average value.
So everything that was more than 90 days ago? Is that
no, this is over the last 90 days. So look at the timestamp and show me timestamps that are greater than 90 days ago, essentially.
And then summarize count, average count by counter name. Wow.
Fairly intuitive, right?
Yeah, well, so I'm just trying to think to myself, is this, like, people know SQL, they know joins, you know, like the general concepts around kind of relational data querying, it feels familiar.
I would argue it's even simpler because this is a pipe-through interface, right?
Ah.
So you don't need to think of the whole query at once. You can go line by line by line and sort of transform your query as you go, which is really useful for investigations, right? Hmm. Because you don't necessarily know where you need to end up. You look at some data, you'll maybe aggregate it, filter it, do all of that to it. So it's a great language for that.
Interesting. So you said it's a pipe through interface. So if I look at this as a person who's never seen it before, I could see these pipes here and ignore them and think that they're there just because it's attractive.
Sure.
But you've put that all on on
in
three lines.
Did it for me, but yeah.
Indeed. This is perf piped through, where piped through. So even for people who are like, you know, Linux people at the command line who understand piping, or PowerShell people, it's a comfortable language.
Exactly. You know, and so people, we've actually gotten that feedback that, hey, it looks like even F-sharp, someone told us it looks like
bit. So. I think it's important for me to remember, though, that this, having that pipe there, you might just think it's a line.
Right.
But it's not.
Yeah, and by the way, you don't have to use the multi-line syntax here. You can have it all on one line if you really wanted to. This looks a lot nicer.
I think that was the click moment. And somehow, by having it be a pipe-based language, it makes me feel more powerful that I can go and apply this now. So I have a bunch of virtual machines. I have a bunch of platforms. I probably have 20 or 30 different resources within Azure, but I'm not using this.
Sure.
What do I need to do to make sure that I can do this? Because this has been here all this time, and now it's got a great new query language.
Yeah.
I should probably take advantage of it.
Yeah, so all you need to do is back in the Azure portal, let's close out of here, the same way you would create any other type of resource, just press the little plus button and look for Log Analytics.
Okay.
And it'll pop up right there. You can read all about it and press create.
Okay.
And that will do it.
And then will it automatically, you know, how will Azure know to route everything to that? Do I need to go to each of my virtual machines, each of my platforms?
You can do it one of two ways. If all of your machines are in Azure, you can either install the agent on them.
Right.
Or you can actually, from the Log Analytics Blade, go and sort of put the check mark on every VM that you want to track, as well as every other type of resource. Right. And this applies to on-prem, by the way, too. So this is hybrid IT you're managing. Mm. So if you have some machines on-prem, some machines in the cloud, you can push all the data into Azure Log Analytics and have it there.
Very cool. And did I see that you had a vanity URL that people could go to and learn more about?
You can go to start with docs.loganalytics.io, and this will kind of take you to our help website where you can learn all about Log Analytics, the query language. You know, we didn't even get to all the string extractions, the joins, there's machine learning, there's all sorts of really cool stuff you can do here. But
fantastic. So we can learn all about that at docs.loganalytics.io within Log Analytics in the Azure portal that you already have.
That's right.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
I am learning all about Azure Log Analytics here on Azure Friday.